Why are there so many files? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question we got. I did a Defender full scan and it scanned over 117,000 files on my computer. Where in the world did they come from? Honestly, 117,000 seems kind of light. Let me show you the result of one of my Windows Defender full scans. So I've just finished a full scan in Windows 11 of my entire PC. This is, of course, one of my Windows 11 demonstration machines. So it doesn't have a lot of things installed on it. It's not one of my more heavily used machines. But if you take a look, you can see that in that full scan, it claims to have scanned over a million separate files. Now, as we'll see in a moment, that count isn't quite what you think it is, but it is still a very, very large number. What I want to do is have you use a tool called DU for disk usage. If you've installed the sysinternals tools, you'll find that one of the tools that it has installed is in fact the DU tool. That is a command line tool. So we'll flip over to the Windows command prompt. In this case, I've run an administrative command prompt so that we have access to all of the files on our system. And I will cd or change directory to the root of the drive. Now I'm going to run du space period. Period means do the disk usage on the current directory and everything below it. I'll hit enter. And of course, it's going to take a few minutes to scan the entire hard drive. What it's going to do is tell us how many files there are here and, as the name implies, tell us how much space is taken up by all those files and folders. So, DU is telling me that I have 147,000 files on this machine. Yep, that's different than the million files that Windows Defender claimed to have scanned. And I'll explain that one in just a minute. But still, 147,000 files, that's a lot of files. Where are they all coming from? Well, the answer is that they're coming from a number of different places. I'm going to now go over to the Windows directory and run that same tool. That way, it'll tell us exactly how many files are included in Windows itself. So Windows is responsible for 88,000 files. That's a lot of files. And when you think about it, Windows itself is incredibly complicated. It's incredibly complex. There are lots and lots of features and functionality that honestly you and I just don't use, but they're still in the operating system for those people who do. Also, lots of different language files, also lots of different backup files. For example, the files that the system file checker might use to restore any damaged system files are there as well, which implies that for a very large number of files, there's actually two copies, the copy currently in use and then the backup copy that the system file checker might use. The bottom line here is for Windows itself, yeah, it's complicated and it's big. And the way that it is distributed across multiple different files and folders in the Windows folder is a function of just how they decided to divvy up the work. The important thing to realize is that, yeah, there's a lot of stuff in Windows, even if you don't use it. Now, there's more to my system than just Windows. For example, I also happen to have Microsoft 365, aka Microsoft Office, installed on this machine. So if I go to Program Files, Microsoft Office, and now run that same tool, DU space period, we can see how many files are included in Microsoft Office itself. And it's over 8,000. 8,000 files to give you your word processor, your spreadsheet, your PowerPoint tools, and so forth. Again, it's a combination of how the tools are broken up into pieces so that pieces can be shared, organized, and built properly, and things like features that you don't necessarily use but are still included in the product. Yeah, Microsoft Office is really big. Now, there's more to it than just Windows and the programs you have installed. Of course, you probably have many more programs installed on your system. But there's also the data that they create. So what I want to do now is take a look at the AppData folder that is associated with my login account. So you can see that in users/askleo, askleo is my login account for this machine. You'll see that there are a number of folders here. And yes, there's documents and so forth where you might have your files, the files you care about. Chances are you may not have documents measured in the thousands. Where we want to look actually is a hidden folder called AppData. That's where programs and Windows itself keep data that is specific to your user account, things like your settings. And in the case of, say, Thunderbird, it actually stores your actual email in this folder. So if we take a look, we can see that, yep, there's a few things. There's local, local, low, roaming. The distinctions on those really doesn't matter that much. But once again, we'll do a du space dot, and we'll find that there are a lot of files and folders here. In fact, there are 27,000 files in this folder tree. That's Windows and your applications basically managing your data and everything associated with running whatever it is they run. Now, there is that original question of, given that we came up with close to 150,000 files on the machine completely, why did Windows Defender report over a million? It's interesting. Windows Defender actually looks inside of zip files and other archive files. Remember that zip files and other archives like MSIs, Microsoft Installer files, the old cabinet files, and a few other file formats, they are all files that themselves contain other files. For example, let's head over here to Windows File Explorer, and you'll see that I have combo.zip. That is a file, a zip file, that I created that contains exactly two files. In fact, if I open it, you can see that there are two text files in it. However, if I now ask Windows Defender to scan this, which I can do with Show More Options and then scan with Microsoft Defender, you'll see that three files were scanned. I only asked it to scan the zip file, but the zip file contains two files for a total of three, the original physical file plus the files that it contains. It gets more interesting. I'm going to go ahead and close that because you'll also see that I have an example.xlsx file. That is a spreadsheet file for Microsoft Excel in the newer X format. What a lot of people don't realize is that that's a container. It's a file that contains other files. And if I now do the same thing, right-click on it, show more options, and scan with Microsoft Defender, you'll see that one file actually resulted in 35 files being scanned. What that means is that one file, that .xlsx file, actually contains 34 other files within it. That, to a large degree, is what explains this huge discrepancy, because there are a lot of archive and container files distributed throughout Windows and other applications. MSI files are one of them, but there are a bunch of others, and Windows Defender, Microsoft Defender, is doing actually what we want. We want it to actually scan the contents of these things to make sure that it finds any malware that might be included inside of a zip file or other container. But that's where all those files come from. In your case, 117,000, like I said, seems kind of light. You can see here on my machine, which honestly doesn't have a lot of things going on except maybe for Microsoft Office, I've got a million files being reported by Windows Defender out of the 250,000 files that are actually on the hard drive. I hope that helps clarify just where all those files are coming from. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/164029. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.